Happy Janmashtami to all our readers and viewers, and welcome to today's Tech News Bulletin brought to you by IT Voice. Click the subscribe button to stay updated. Zoom is introducing a free AI companion for its paid users, leveraging large language models, including OpenAI's, for summarizing meetings and drafting messages, named Zoom IQ. This feature will allow users to generate AI-driven meeting summaries and responses. The AI assistant will be available across the Zoom platform, aiding in chat drafting and long chat thread summaries. Zoom commits to not using customer data for AI training, addressing past controversies. The AI companion will be available to paid subscribers by this fall. Next up, we have, ahead of its launch, Realme Narzo 60X 5G appears on Geekbench, revealing key specifications. Expected to be powered by the MediaTek Dimensity 6100 Plus chipset, it suggests a rebranding of the Realme 11X 5G. The device is equipped with 6GB RAM and operates on an Android 13-based system. It scored 727 points in the single-core test and 1915 points in the multi-core test on Geekbench 6. The Geekbench listing provides a sneak peek into the upcoming smartphone's capabilities. India's first monthly subscription-based healthcare benefits provider, OnSurety, debuts its first non-health product, Cyber Insurance for SMEs. OnSurety Plus is geared towards fortifying business security with tailored insurance products to counter operational risks. India witnessed 13.91 lakh cyber attacks in 2022, with real numbers potentially higher. The surge in e-commerce and digital platforms necessitates cyber insurance, especially for SMEs, irrespective of their digital advancement. Established corporations have robust insurance, but SMEs need to prioritize cyber coverage in today's digital world. Specialist distributor TechnoBind announces its collaboration with exposure management solutions provider Skybox Security. Skybox delivers an integrated platform supporting attack surface management, vulnerability management, and security policy management. This partnership allows security teams to emphasize strategic business ventures while ensuring protection. Skybox award-winning continuous exposure management platform aids every stage of exposure management, maximizing security efficiency. The integrated solution simplifies exposure management for businesses. Sun Mobility will equip over 15,000 of Swiggy's delivery e-bikes in the upcoming year. This initiative will reduce CO2 emissions by 20,000 tons annually, underlining Swiggy's dedication to eco-friendly transportation. The collaboration grants Swiggy's delivery fleet access to Sun Mobility's advanced battery swapping tech and extensive swapping station network. Introduction of e-bikes boosts Swiggy's commitment to fast, reliable, and green deliveries. Sun Mobility aims to transform last-mile deliveries, advocating sustainable transportation in India. Next up, we have Oppo unveils the A38 smartphone in UAE with specifications on its site, but no pricing or availability details yet. The Oppo A38 boasts a 6.56-inch IPS LCD panel with an HD Plus resolution, 90Hz refresh rate, and a maximum brightness of 720 nits. Its display supports both the 100% DCI P3 and 100% sRGB color gamut and font, and 89.90% screen-to-body ratio. Weighing 190 grams, its dimensions measure 163.74 × 75.3 × 8.16 mm. Key features include its water drop notch design, making it visually appealing. At last, Samsung releases the Wear OS 4 update for Galaxy Watch 4 and Watch 4 Classic in the US. The update includes easier addition of watch faces and tiles, enhanced sleep coaching, and new call controls. Additional features like backup and restore, controlling the watch without touch, and enhanced security are part of the update. The update is aimed at improving the overall user experience and safety. The build number of the update concludes in HWH3, and some apps might require separate subsequent updates. This is Harshish signing off. Stay tuned and follow IT Voice for the latest tech news.
शिव शक्ति पॉइंट आ चुका है। प्रज्ञान और विक्रम रोवर दोनों भी स्लीप मोड में जा चुके हैं। फर्स्ट टेस्टिंग करनी थी उनको, हॉप इमेजेस देखनी थी, तो उन्होंने उसकी टेस्टिंग करी थी। बट जब लूना नाइट आती है तो क्या होता है कि इनका जो डार्कनेस है इसके अंदर इनको सर्वाइव करना बहुत ज्यादा जरूरी है। इसके कंपोनेंट्स डिस्ट्रॉय भी हो सकते हैं, हम यूज करते हैं उन पे इफेक्ट पड़ता है। और लूनर लाइट पे अगर हम डार्कनेस में रहेंगे और स्लीप मोड में रहेंगे तो इन सारी चीजों का इफेक्ट नहीं पड़ेगा, क्योंकि हम ऑपरेट ही नहीं कर रहे हैं। सबसे बड़ा फायदा इसरो ने कहा है कि 22 सितंबर तक इसको स्लीप मोड में रहना पड़ेगा। सो वी ऑल आर वेटिंग फॉर अगेन इट्स सक्सेस। सो अगर आपको पसंद आया तो लाइक।